Hello everyone. Before I start pouring, I want to explain to you all how I do the preparation of my MDF boards. I got some questions about it and I want to show you all how I do it. And this is my next project. It's going to be a large coffee table again. And what I did is I bought two MDF boards of 12 millimeters thick, and I glued them together, and also with some small screws. There you can see it. I screwed them also together. So that's what I did first, and after that I draw my design on the board. So it's very large one, it's 60 by 120 centimeters. And after that, I saw the shape out with a jigsaw. I think it's called the jigsaw. Maybe I can show you all. Wait a minute. That's this one. I think this is a jigsaw. So I saw the shape out, and after that I sanded the edges on the other side, because this is the bottom and this is the other side, because I want the edges a little bit round so that the resin will flow over much easy. After that I cleaned it with alcohol to get all the dust from my MDF board. And then I started to prime the boards. First I did three layers of gesso on the front and on the back. After that I put two layers of acrylic paint, and this one is black, so you can see. And then I tape the back with some masking tape, and it's the tape from the company I also buy my resin from. And now I'm done with that, and what I'm going to do next is turn it around and then sand the front so that it's very smooth, the surface. Because this is a little, has a little bit of a structure. I like that from the, for the back, but for the front I need it to be as flat as possible, no structure. So and also the sides, don't forget the sides, because otherwise you get air bubbles coming out of the wood, and that's not good, because then you get also air bubbles in your resin. So prime the sides very good, and then my shape is done, my MDF board is done. So that's how I prepare my my MDF board. It's not that difficult, because some people wanted to see how I did the shape with a jigsaw, but it's not that difficult. So you draw it on your board and you get the jigsaw and you follow the line that you draw on your board. So that's what I wanted to show you first, and now we can go to the pouring. So I'm ready to pour, and for this coffee table, because that is what I'm going to make, I'm using the Stone Coat Art Coat. So I'm very excited how it will work, and I already mixed my colors, and the mixing went very well. It's a little bit thinner than the Mastercars I'm normally used, but I don't mind, I like that. I already started with some black, and that's the Midnight Black of Lures, and on top I'm using this black of Stonecoat. And also another shade of black, that's the graphite or graphite, I don't know how you call it in English, but it's from just resin. So you get a little bit of contrast in the black. And what I'm trying to do for this coffee table is a kind of a sunset with a stormy sea, with a wild sea and some rocks. So the black needs to resemble some rocks. Now I'm pouring a line of aluminum of Eli Gem, that's the resin metal. Also some lines in the black. And I'm not going to do the whole first layer. Some parts of this first layer I don't want to bleed into each other, so I leave them open. So now some heat, and I'm trying to blend the colors into each other and also blow the aluminum over the black to create some special effects. Because I know that this black of stone coat can give some nice effects. And also in the Midnight Black of Lures, I put in some sparkle pearl of Color Obsession to give it a little bit more sparkle. So the next color is some white, Angel White of Lures. And some Region Bright Yellow, that's also from Eli Gem, that's a new paste. On top of that, this white of Stone Coat. So I'm using two different whites and also two different blacks. Around a little bit of white of Stone Coat. And some yellow must resemble the sun. And this is only the first layer, and you know I always put some details in the second layer, so it's all about laying those colors down. And I also did not tape the sides because I wanted to flow over the sides to get that drippy effect. This is the saffron or saffron of just resin, because if I look at a sunset I see some white, yellow, different shades of orange. Now I'm using the primary elements orange peel, a different shade of orange but also very sparkly. A white line that must resemble the horizon line. Some yellow again. Little bit of white of Stone Coat, and it's again a large project, but I like large projects that I have to work several times on one project. I like that. also some flame orange, that's an ink, another shade of orange, not a lot, a little bit, my dogs are very noisy, sorry for that. Also some white lines in the orange. And I go with what my feeling tells me to do. I had a little kind of a plan in my head that I want to have a sunset with a wild sea and some rocks. But how to do it, I let my feelings tell me what I need to do. So a little bit of heat to blend some colors. I try to blow some colors over the white. There you see me do that. And now I'm using the Muddy Seas of Color Obsession. That's a paste. A very dark blue. And the Reef Blue of Color Obsession. Very sparkly, this color is very nice. Also some aluminum in the horizon, in the sunset. It needs a little bit more sparkle. Also in the against the blue in the water, also a little bit of aluminum. Again some midnight black of Lares, very deep black color, very nice. And the black of Stone Coat. Again the Reef Blue of Color Obsession against the black of Stone Coat, and that I let bleed into each other because I want to know which effect it will give me. Again the Muddy Seas of Color Obsession. some white over on top of the blue. And that must resemble the foam that you have on the waves. Again, some heat to blend all those colors. Yeah, and the stone coat, art coat works very well. It's a little bit thinner, what I already said, as the MasterCast, what I normally use. But I like it that it's a little bit thinner. Then you can move it around much easier. And what I like about this resin is that the working time is much more than with the MasterCast. It's almost, yeah, it's an hour, and maybe a little bit more. And the smell, yeah, it doesn't smell that much. I like that. Now I'm trying to blend the white into the blue. That it isn't a straight line anymore. My last bit of aluminum. And my last bit of white. And that's the white of stone coat. Yeah, you need a lot of resin for such a large project. Last bit of saffron, of just resin. Again, some heat. And what I also like about this resin is that it's heat resistant up until 500 degrees. I like that. Now I'm trying to blow the blue over the white to create some cells. Also blending the white in the horizon, in the sunset. Yeah, at the end of this video, also a close-up. And then you can wait until the end of this video, then you can see that if the colors are blended into each other and all the sparkle. And yeah, all the black parts that you see in the middle, in the sea part, in the water part, that will stay open, because I don't want that parts to bleed into each other. And also under the horizon, it needs to be as straight as possible, not that much bleeding into each other of colors. So that's why I'm leaving that open with no resin. So when it's dry, then I can fill in those gaps and also add some details on top of the rest. So now we can go to the close-up. So I couldn't move it because it's too heavy, so I film it inside. And there you see up close what needs to be the sun, the nice yellow. But it needs a little bit more detail. But it sparkles a lot, and that's because of the saffron, because that is a sparkly color. And also the primary elements, the orange peel, worked very well. And the orange you see in the white, that's the orange flame of Eli Gem. That's an ink. And you get that watercolor effect, what I like. So it bleeded nicely into each other. Also the aluminum. There you see it. Very sparkly. But yeah, in the second layer there will be more details. And all the black parts you see will also be another color, an orange or a blue one. There are also some nice effects with the white and the dark brown color, but I didn't use any brown, so it gives a nice depth to it. This part I like also, it gives that watercolor effect, what I already said. There, the sun, it needs a little bit more detail, more colors, more depth, but I will do that in the second layer. So now to the water part, what I already have. Very sparkly color, and the, especially the reef blue is very sparkly, that's from Color Obsession. Bleed it nicely into each other. I'm pleased what I have now. And also the Muddy Seas of Color Obsession, that's the dark blue color. Very nice contrast with the Reef Blue. There you see the sparkle. Also some aluminum of Eli Gem, the resin metal, some cells. That's because of the stone coat. Those two pigments, the black and white of stone coat, are amazing. They work very well and you get some nice effects of them. There are also some small cells. Now to the rocks that must resemble the rocks. What I already said is that I mixed into the Midnight Black of Lures some sparkle pearl of Color Obsession. There you can see it sparkles a lot. And also the aluminum of Ilagem, the resin metal, very nice. And also the graphite, or how do you call it in English? That's the another shade of black. Gives a little bit of a contrast. Very nice. So this was part one. The first layer is not totally done. I need to let it dry and then I will fill in those gaps. And if you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. If you have tips or questions or comments, place them under the video or send me an email. Give me a thumbs up if you like what I'm doing. And you can also find me on Facebook and Instagram. All the links you want to know where I buy my materials or where you can find me are in the description box. And I want to thank you all for watching. And I see you in the next video. Bye.